In the last class, just we have discussed regarding equation of motion and graphical representation of motion. In the previous class, we have derived three equations of motions using mathematical concept. Or we can say that mathematically we have derived equation of motion. That is, first one was v equal to u plus at. Second one is s equal to ut plus half a t square. And third one is v square plus u square plus 2s. V square equal to u square plus 2s. Now, another method that you'd have to know, and usually come in the examination, in the internal examination or even in final examination, you will be asked to derive equation of motion using a graphical method. So there are two methods to derive equation of motion. One is mathematical, another is graphical. Mathematical method was already discussed. Today we will discuss about graphical method to derive equation of motions. So so far you all of you must have known about the velocity time graph. So in order to derive equation of motion, we use velocity time graph and various concepts associated with the graph. So here, first equation of motion is to be derived using graphical method. So first of all, you have to draw a velocity time graph for an object moving initially with a uniform velocity u, and thereafter it starts accelerating and acquires a final velocity v after time t. So look at, this is the graph. This is the graph that you have to look over. Velocity time graph, velocity is taken along y-axis and time is taken along x-axis. So initially when time t was zero, object's velocity was not zero. That was the velocity from O to A, that is u. But at the time t equal to zero, object started increasing its velocity with constant rate, say with constant acceleration. Therefore, graph will be a straight line between velocity and time. So this is a graph, a straight line graph, indicating that velocity is increasing uniformly. And rate of increase of velocity, rate of change of velocity can be obtained by obtaining slope of the graph. So far we know that rate of change of velocity itself is called acceleration. So in order to derive or in order to calculate acceleration from by looking the graph, we have to calculate slope of the graph. That is, slope of graph is just equal to ratio of change in velocity to time taken for that change. So here, slope is just equal to, in another language, perpendicular upon base. This is perpendicular. B to D is a perpendicular and A to D is a base. So when you find the slope of these two, you get acceleration. So for the first equation of motion, we know that acceleration is equal to change in velocity upon time taken for it. So here, now slope equal to perpendicular upon base. Perpendicular is BD in triangle ABD. BD is perpendicular and AD is the base. This is the base. So ratio of perpendicular to base is equal to slope of the velocity time graph. And this slope itself is called acceleration, so denoted as A. So A equal to BD upon AD. Now question is that AD, ये लेक्चर आपको उपलब्ध रहेगा YouTube पर, आप फिर से वहां से बढ़िया से कॉपी पर नोट कर लेना. ओके, सो डोंट वरी. हियर नाउ ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड, BD इज जस्ट इक्वल टू AE. BD इज जस्ट इक्वल टू AE बिकॉज parallel and just like a square or rectangle, so the opposite sides of a square or rectangle are equal. So BD equal to AE. So in place of BD we can write AE, and we have written here in place of BD we have written here AE. Similarly, AD is just equal to OC. So we have written here in place of AD OC, because OC represents time and AE represents velocity. Therefore, we have written it in that term. Clear? Now, in place of AE, we have to put final velocity of object becomes V at the time, at the end of time t. So, V can be expressed as OE minus OA. This is change in velocity. OE minus OA equal to AE. So OE equal to O2E and OA O2A, and then subtracting OE minus OA, then we get AE. And similarly divided by OC. Now place the value of OE. OE equal to what? Final velocity V. From O to E equal to final velocity V. So right here, in place of OE equal to V, and in place of OA equal to U, and in place of OT equal to T, so we get here A equal to V minus U divided by T, and hence cross multiplication, A into T equal to V minus U, so V minus U equal to AT, and hence V equal to U plus AT. We have direct equation of motion, first equation of motion using graph. So remember, while plotting the graph, you must plot the graph velocity time graph. While driving equation of motion, any equation of motion, whether it is velocity, first equation, second equation, or third equation, always same graph will be used. And now, next, second equation of motion, remember here, same graph is there. Only difference is that in second equation of motion, velocity V is not involved. Second equation is S equal to ut plus half at u square. It's not V involved in the expression. Therefore, we have to eliminate V and try to understand velocity time graph. Here we have to calculate area. Why area? Because S represents displacement or distance. So from velocity time graph, how can one find out the displacement or distance? So from velocity time graph, by finding area under the graph, one can find out the velocity, displacement or distance, because we know that area under velocity time graph gives displacement or distance. Therefore, here our geometrical shape is trapezium. So trapezium, this side and this side is parallel. We know that in trapezium, at least two sides remains parallel. Therefore, this is longer side and this is shorter side, and this is the width or altitude of the trapezium. So we know that in order to find out area of trapezium, and name of trapezium is what? O A B C O. You go there like this. This is the trapezium, and this is the area under the velocity time graph. Therefore, area under velocity time graph is area of trapezium here in this figure. So area of trapezium, formula of area of trapezium is what? Half into altitude into sum of parallel side. So area under this graph equal to half into altitude into sum of parallel sides. So remember, C to B and O to A, these two sides are parallel. Therefore, we find out sum of these two parallel sides. And altitude is this one. Perpendicular distance between the two parallel sides is called altitude. So this is the altitude OC. So area equal to displacement. Area becomes just equal to displacement. Area under velocity time graph is equal to displacement. Therefore, here area equal to S equal to half into perpendicular altitude OC into sum of parallel side OA plus CB. Now we have to place S equal to half into OC equal to what? T. So we place here T into OA equal to what? U. OA equal to U plus O and CB equal to what? CB equal to OE. That is equal to V. Final velocity becomes V. So CB equal to V. Now after multiplying by T, I'm breaking the graph. V equal to, from first equation, we know that V equal to U plus AT because V is not to be involved in the equation. So V is to be eliminated. So we have eliminated V by U plus AT. So next, after that, U plus U equal to 2U and 2U plus AT, and then we multiply by time T. So 2U into T plus A into AT into T. So AT square. So half into 2UT plus AT square. And after breaking the bracket, we get half into 2UT. That means half and 2 will be cancelled out and you will get UT. And plus half AT square. Root. This is the graphical method. So same graph has been used. No another graph. Only that you have to remember that it is shaded in order to show that area under this graph represents displacement. So in order to find out displacement S, we have to find out area under this graph. Now third equation of motion is to be derived. Again, you look at this same figure, same graph is there. So all the three equations of motion can be derived using same graph. In this equation of motion, our expression is V square equal to U square plus 2AS. So try to understand here, S is displacement, V is final velocity, U is initial velocity, A is acceleration. But in this expression, no time involved. No time is involved. Therefore, time is to be eliminated. So again, you have to apply the same formula. Area under this velocity time graph is S equal to sum of S equal to area under trapezium. That is half into sum of parallel side into altitude. So same formula has been applied. Only difference is that V and U remains in its place. And time t is to be replaced. So try to understand from this equation, t equal to 2s divided by t equal to v plus u. So time t has been eliminated. Now this v plus u is to be placed in which equation? Here, in this equation. Or in which equation? Again, from first equation, you see that V equal to U plus AT. So V minus U equal to AT. So therefore, V minus U equal to A into T. Now multiplying these two equations. See, this is the equation one. V plus U equal to 2 into S by T. This is equation one. Now from equation first, V equal to U plus AT, therefore V minus U equal to AT. This is equation second. Now multiplying equation first and second, we get V square minus U square equal to 2A square. This is A plus B and this is A minus B. So becomes A square minus B square. Now LHS side, RHS side, 2S upon T into AT. So T and AT, TT cancel out. So only 2AS will be there. So V square minus V square equal to 2AS. Now we have V square equal to U square plus 2AS. This is the equation of motion. Third equation of motion, that's all about that. So you have to practice to derive equation of motion using graphical method. Now next topic is uniform circular motion. Try to understand uniform circular motion, that you have to understand. You know that motion of a body in a circular or angular curve path is called circular motion. When a body moves on a circular track, this is called circular motion, uniform circular motion. This motion also known as a circular motion or angular motion or curvilinear motion. So when body moves in a circular path with uniform speed, then what motion of the body is said to be uniform circular motion. But remember that a speed of body may be uniform while moving on a circular path, but velocity of body cannot be uniform while moving on a circular path, because direction of motion is instantly changing continuously. Therefore, here it is in note that velocity changes at each and every instant of time, and hence body experiences acceleration. And although a speed is uniform, but its acceleration is not zero. So this is the only one case where motion is said to be uniform, but acceleration is non-zero due to variation of direction of motion. So say if a body starts from this point at time t equal to zero and move like this and this and again come to this point, how much distance does the body cover during that journey from a starting and then coming to a starting point? So total distance covered by this ball or body will be equal to circumference of this circle. And we know that circumference is equal to what? 2 pi r. This is total distance traveled by the body. Now total time taken by the body while coming from here to here again equal to t. Now velocity of the body, a speed of the body, circular motion, in circular motion, a speed of the body is equal to total distance traveled by the body divided by total time taken. So 2 pi r divided by t. Total distance is 2 pi r and time is t. So this is the velocities of circular motion, velocity in circular motion. This is the formula. Now examples of uniform circular motion, try to understand. Artificial satellite move under uniform circular motion around the earth. That is an example of uniform circular motion. Now most moon moves in a uniform circular motion around the earth. This is another example of uniform circular motion. Now tips of seconds hands of the clock exhibits uniform circular motion. Now try to understand. In your watch, there will be three hands: minute hands, hour hands, and second hands. So second's hand moves in a circular way with uniform circular motion. That's why it gives accurate time. If it would have moved with non-uniform circular motion, then time would have been changing day by day, and accuracy was lost. Now, so try to understand, the objects such as body of red car, aeroplane, ship, moving man, earth rotated with sun and galaxy are taken from the various websites. So you can even collect a moving body in that case. So I think that your chapter has been completed, and I will give you some work to practice. First of all, that you have to complete today. I will give you the work, and I think that all of you should take on your WhatsApp group. I will just send, and this lecture will be available on your YouTube channel that I have already mentioned there. So for today, that's all about, and you have to complete that exercise that I'm going to share. You have to complete that. Okay, all the best.
Thank you, sir.